Little Bighorn. This image is one of the famous images of the last stand, Custer's last stand, on June 25th, 1876, on a little hillside in Montana. The artist got nothing right except the terrain. And that's what we want to kind of talk about tonight, is what physical evidence, literally physical evidence, artifacts, can bring to a story in putting this whole thing together. We're looking at it from an archaeological and anthropological perspective of how to put a story together on 2 days, June 25, 26, 1876.
In terms of the troopers' lives and deaths, there were a number of things that really stood out on the skeletons. Oral health was one of them, back problems another, and injuries and mutilations. Remains were found on the battlefield. They were taken to the Custer National Cemetery and placed in there among the other veterans. And typically their headstones read unknown. So Doug got permission and excavated six of those graves. And what he found were skeletal remains also of the troopers. So what we did with those remains was we did a couple things. One was we had a purpose to try to learn about the troopers' lives and their deaths. The second was to try to change those titles on the headstones, to try to identify individuals.
We use memory and history in archaeology to teach about the past. Is there real relevance today? I mean, you're sitting here in the audience, you tell me. It's interesting, right? But there is relevance for today's world. The U.S. military still uses this site and many others as lessons in counterinsurgency. So there are relevance today to the U.S. military and to us. So it's very valuable.